Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Welcome back. Hey, you know, now that you've got some great ideas on how to add wow factor to five major parts of a song, in this lesson, you're going to learn how to put those ideas to work. We're going to use a simple but well-known song that just about everybody knows by heart and can probably already play. Happy Birthday. We'll use a few simple riffs for the intro using hammer-ons, pull-offs, and slides. And for the verse, I'll teach you how to include the melody with the chords. Then for the ending, we'll use two separate techniques, a nice long fretboard run, and a big ending. So get your pick, get your guitar, meet me in the studio. I'm going to show you how to put wow factor into Happy Birthday. Okay, now Happy Birthday is in the key of G, and it has three basic chords, G, D, and C. But there is a D7 there at the end, so I guess it's actually a four-chord song. Now, the average everyday guitar strummer is going to strum Happy Birthday something like this. He's not going to use an intro, no riffs, no licks. He'll just start singing happy, and when he says birthday, he'll come in on that G. So it'd be something like this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear so-and-so. Happy birthday to you. Now that's fine, that's nothing wrong with that. But we're gonna put wow factor into it. So we're gonna use a little bit of an intro and then we're gonna play the melody along with the chords. Our version would sound something like this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear so-and-so. Happy birthday to you. Now look, I realize that you may not be playing it that way every time you play it at a party, but this is a good song for you to learn how to get your intros in. You already know the melody of the song, so it's easy for you to start adding the melody to the chords, and it's a simple song. So look at it that way too, not just that you're going to play it this way every time. That may have been a little bit too much to put into that, but it's a good lesson for you to learn on this. So let me bring it in close, and I'll show you what I'm doing. Okay, now the very first thing you need to do when you're going to play a melody with the chords is you got to look at the notes of the melody to see which notes are going to fit in that you can play with the chords in that open register. So this song is in the key of G. So let's see what we've got. Let's see if we can get the first few notes to that melody and see what's going to go with that G chord. Okay, so it's an open D. Happy birthday to... Whoops, that's not it. Happy birthday to you. There it is there. Okay, so we got... Happy birthday to you. Now, all those notes right there, I know those are all in G. So it'd be easy enough to play that. If I strum a G chord, I could play... Happy birthday to... See, that's open. Happy birthday to... But that note right there is not. But if you listen to the song, that changes to a D. Happy birthday to you. So you could do that open D like that and that'd be okay. But that note is really right there on that fourth string. That's that F sharp, okay? Now you can play that D chord, put your pinky over there, and you can pick that up and it would really sound good. Now it's not necessary. You could play it without that and you're not gonna really notice it. If you can get that finger in there, and my suggestion is that you try and do it because that's gonna get you just more dexterity in your fingers. So it'd be like this. Happy birthday to you. Okay. But we wanna do a little intro even before we get to that. Okay, so let's take a look at what I did for that intro. On the intro, all I did was a walk down, and it's that same walk down or almost identical to the walk down you learned on those basic finger exercises at the very beginning of the course. And all I did was a walk down like this. Okay, so it's just hammer-ons, I'm just pull-offs. Then I'm going to use my ring finger to get down to that 4th fret on that 3rd. 4th fret on 4. Now I do the 3rd and 2nd string, 3rd and 2nd fret there. Now I'm going to do a little different. I'm doing a hammer-on open, hammer-on 2, open 4. Then I get to my G chord. Happy. Now, instead of just saying happy on that open, I'm throwing in another little riff, and all I'm doing there is a hammer-on on the open 5 to second on 5. Happy, happy. And then I get my happy birthday. That's when I put my G chord down, but I'm going to put my middle finger on that second fret of the 4th string to pick up that happy birthday, happy birthday. Now look at my strumming hand. It's just a nice smooth strum. Happy birthday, happy birthday. So let's try this again. Happy birthday to you. Now 2 is that open 3. So you just want to emphasize the open 3. Happy birthday to you. When you're strumming, you don't have to hit that full G chord. You just hit the notes that you're trying to emphasize for the melody. Happy birthday to you. There's that D with that F sharp bass. Okay, now it's happy birthday. You do that again, but one of the things that you can do here, if you've got the skills right now and you want to practice this, go ahead and do that same happy birthday, that same little run we did earlier. This time you do it with your index finger. Remember how I was saying you got to be able to use multiple fingers to do the same runs? Well, here what we do is that index finger, and then you come back here for to you, happy birthday to you. Okay, so let's try that. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Okay, now what you want to do, what's the next part of it? Now we got to find out the rest of that melody. So be happy. Nope, that's not it. Happy birthday. There it is right there. Happy birthday. Okay, so it's a little walk down right there. Happy birthday. Now we got to get that. Now we've got to get those melodies. Happy birthday. Okay, so that's just a little bit of a walk down right there. It's an open 3. Now you got to pick that 4th fret up on that 4th string. That's the melody right there. Okay, so what can we play when we're in that G chord? Well, we can do that same little riff, happy, and then you got to get all the way up here, happy. So you got that G chord. You can take your fingers off, because this is what you want to emphasize right here. Okay, now you can do that. You can do that walk down, but I think it'll sound better if you put a little riff in there. So that's what I did. Now remember, these are just ideas. You may have better ideas than this. So it'd be happy birthday, dear so-and-so. Okay? And all I'm doing there, remember when we do a riff, you can do any of those notes as long as when you hit that chord, that's where you're starting your next riff or the chord. Happy birthday, da 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 da. Now what's the next part? So it's like happy birthday, open 3. So that D, that's want to make sure you emphasize that open third.
Happy birthday.
There's that D7. Now I'm going to do a little bit of a slide to get a pause in there. Once I do there, you learn this slide in that basic finger exercise as well. You don't ever have to play the same notes, so you don't have to memorize that. So that would be your ending. Okay? Now I'll play it all the way through with you. I want to show you something. When you do a big ending like that, one time I was doing it, and when I was going up and down those strings, I had my fingernail really close to those strings, and my fingernail got caught underneath the first string. It cut about half of it off. I never was in so much pain. So now I've learned a lesson. When I do a big ending, and I do them a lot, when I do that big ending, I make sure my finger is way up above those strings, and I've actually got it arched just a little bit like that. I hold the pick a little bit different, so I know I'm not going to have my nail. My nail is actually pointing towards the bridge of that string, because I don't want to ever do that again. That way, if it ever hits, it's going to hit the fleshy part, not that nail. So good lesson to learn right there. So that's how I do a big ending. And there you go. Now practice that. Try using those. If you're a beginner, you may not want to put all of those little licks in there, but try to do the best you can, and I'll see you in the next video.